what would each planet look like in place of the Moon? The Moon is our natural satellite. It causes the tides on Earth and lights up the night sky on full moon nights. Life on Earth is linked to the Moon, but what if we changed the Moon to a planet? What effects would it have on Earth if we put Jupiter or Venus in the place of the Moon? What would the sky look like if Saturn was in the place of the Moon? In this video, we will let your imagination run wild and explore what would happen if we put each planet in the place of the Moon. Let's get started. Mercury. Let's start with the closest planet to the Sun. Mercury is a little planet, but bigger than the Moon. If we were to place Mercury in the place of the Moon, we would have a celestial object in our night sky with a diameter of 4,880 kilometers, about 3.7 times that of the Moon, giving it a more predominant appearance from Earth. Also, due to its proximity to our planet, Mercury would be a much brighter object in the night sky than the Moon, with an apparent magnitude ranging from minus 2.5 to minus 0.8. Mercury's closeness to Earth would also have a significant effect on the tides. Its gravity, greater than the Moon's, would cause extreme tides. The Earth's oceans would experience significant changes in their level and distribution, affecting both the living beings that inhabit them and the human activities that depend on them, such as fishing and maritime transport. As for its appearance in the night sky, Mercury would show a surface covered with craters and cliffs visible from Earth, thanks to its larger diameter and brightness. Mercury is a very different planet from the Moon, and its presence in our night sky would be a fascinating sight for astronomy lovers. Despite being the closest planet to the Sun, Mercury is a celestial object that has not been explored in detail. If Mercury were in the Moon's place, we would have a much closer and brighter object in the night sky, allowing for a more accessible and detailed exploration of its surface and features. Furthermore, this exploration could reveal important information about the solar system's history and how the planets formed. Of all the planets, Mercury is the one that most resembles the Moon. So if we replaced the Moon with this planet, we would not notice a big difference other than in the brightness during the nights of the full Moon, or rather, full Mercury. Venus. If we were to place Venus in the place of the Moon, we would have an impressive and brilliant sight in our night sky. Although Venus is slightly smaller than Earth, its proximity would make it look significantly more predominant in the sky than the Moon. Also, Venus is known to be one of the brightest objects, meaning its presence in our night sky would be even more impressive. However, because Venus is so much more massive than the Moon, its proximity would significantly affect Earth's tides, leading to flooding and other coastal problems such as rising sea levels and moving large air masses in naturally desert areas. Also, placing Venus in place of the Moon would mean noticeable effects on Earth's tilt and the length of days and months. Because Venus rotates in the opposite direction to Earth, there is a chance that the Earth's rotation would slow down, meaning that days and months would be significantly longer on our planet. Let's remember that the Moon presents tidal coupling with the Earth because the Earth's force of gravity is greater than that of the Moon. But Venus has a diameter and a mass very similar to that of the Earth, so its influence on the rotation of our planet would also be more significant. This could also influence the tilt of the Earth, leading to significant changes in the seasons and global climate. Color-wise, Venus would look like a massive ball of bright yellowish color from Earth. This color is caused by the dense atmosphere of Venus, which reflects a large amount of the sunlight that reaches the planet. In fact, due to its dense atmosphere, Venus may be the planet that would reflect the lightest from the Sun to the Earth, reflecting 60% more light than the Moon reflects. This would cause the nights to stop being so dark, and it would even be possible to see at night under its intense light. Placing Venus in the place of the Moon results in both planets orbiting each other around a center of mass in common, creating a binary system in which both planets would revolve around each other as they orbit the Sun. If this happens, it could be the case that the two planets acquire tidal coupling between them. That is to say, one face of the Earth always points to Venus and one face of Venus always points to the Earth. Something strange, but incredible, don't you think? Mars. With a diameter of about 6,779 kilometers, Mars is twice the size of the Moon. as the Moon has a diameter of 3,476 kilometers. If we put Mars instead of the Moon in the night sky, we would stop seeing our natural satellite white with dark spots and have a giant red ball. Unlike Venus, Mars is not large enough to produce tidal coupling with Earth or to form a binary system of planets revolving around a common center of mass. But with its size, the tidal effects on Earth would be twice as strong as on the Moon. Its proximity would also cause a change in the brightness and apparent size of the night sky, which would be an impressive spectacle for observers on Earth, as the nights, instead of being illuminated with a white light like that of the Moon, would be illuminated with a red light coming from the reflection of light on Mars. As for the effects on Earth, Mars would not significantly impact the tilt of our planet, the length of days and months, or the seasons due to its size and low mass. The most important change would come during eclipses, since both Mars and Mercury and Venus, being larger than the Moon, would hide the Sun for longer on the dates of solar eclipses. Jupiter. Now we turn to the heavyweights, the gas giants. Unlike the rocky planets, they are hundreds of times larger than the Earth. So if we put them in the place of the Moon, the roles would be reversed. That is, they would not orbit around the Earth, but it would be the Earth that would orbit these planets. For example, if we put Jupiter in the place of the Moon, the Earth would become another moon of the 95 that this gigantic planet has. Earth would not look that different from the other moons that orbit Jupiter, such as Ganymede, Io, Europa, or Callisto. These natural satellites are bigger than the Moon, and even Ganymede is bigger than Mercury. If we put Jupiter in place corresponding to the Moon, this planet would cover a vast amount of space, filling much of the space between the Earth and the Moon. Jupiter is 1,321 times larger than Earth, the most massive planet, and by itself, it has more mass than all the other planets in the solar system combined. For this reason, its gravitational force of attraction is immense. If the Earth were to orbit Jupiter, it would have to do so very fast, so that the rate of rotation offsets the gravitational pull of Jupiter, and so we don't plummet into the gas giant. Consequently, the Earth would circle Jupiter every 7 days, just like Ganymede. This would produce an inevitable tidal coupling on Earth, in which one side of the Earth would always be pointing to Jupiter. In addition, the tidal forces exerted by Jupiter on Earth would produce not only the elevation of the ocean waters, but also the movement of magma inside the Earth and the deformation of tectonic plates. This would produce earthquakes, accompanied by sporadic volcanic eruptions, and the emergence of new volcanoes in relatively short periods. It is known that the tidal forces of Jupiter produce eruptions of cryovolcanoes on the satellite Europa. If that happens on that moon, it is most likely that the same will happen to Earth. But instead of ice volcanoes on Earth, we have lava volcanoes that would cause natural disasters, accompanied by extensive clouds of smoke. Orbiting Jupiter would also cause the Earth's axis and seasons to change. All of this would cause drastic changes to our planet, which could make life unable to survive. Regarding the view, as Jupiter is thousands of times bigger than the Moon, it would cover a good part of the sky, covering a large part of the stars we see at night. Solar eclipses would be incredible too. Although the correct term would not be eclipse, but occultation, since Jupiter's massive size would completely hide the Sun for several hours. Unlike what happens in solar eclipses we are accustomed to, the Moon stands between the Earth and the Sun. In an occultation, if the Earth orbited Jupiter, Jupiter would stand between the Earth and the Sun, much like what was featured in the science fiction movie Avatar. In the film, it is shown how on the planet Pandora, this phenomenon occurs. Saturn. The worst-case scenario would undoubtedly be Saturn. Why? Because of the ring of asteroids that surrounds it. Saturn has a vast asteroid ring that characterizes it and makes it stand out from other planets in the solar system. Although the other gas planets also have asteroid rings, Saturn is the largest and most colorful of all. Remember that in all gaseous planets, the Earth would become the Moon, not the other way around. If we were to put Saturn in the place of the Moon, the Earth would orbit very close to its rings, which would not suit us. While the sight would be impressive, eventually Earth's gravity would attract a small portion of these asteroids, causing them to fall as meteorites to the Earth's surface occasionally. And if the movies have taught us anything so far, it's that meteorites are not suitable for life to thrive. In addition to the constant impact of meteorites from Saturn's asteroid ring, Jupiter is large, massive, and has many natural satellites. So the effects on the Earth's surface and atmosphere would be very similar to those that Jupiter would provide. Undoubtedly, orbiting around gas giants is quite a problem. Uranus and Neptune. We have decided to place these two planets at the same point since the conditions we will find in each one will be very similar. To begin with, Uranus and Neptune would look very large from Earth if we place them where the Moon is located, in addition to the fact that they would shine with an intense blue during the night. Its effects on Earth would be milder than those of Jupiter and Saturn, but would equally influence the tides and the length of days and months. On the other hand, these planets are icy. By placing them closer to the Sun, the heat they would receive would also be higher. It is possible that this produces chemical changes in their atmospheres and makes them change color, but that is only a hypothesis based on other similar exoplanets that we have seen in other solar systems. As you can see, in all cases, placing a planet in the place of the Moon would cause slight changes and the destruction of life on the planet. This reminder helps us realize how lucky we are to have the Moon as a natural satellite.